تقربوا تقربوا شوي عشان الناس. تقرب نعم. Sit next to each other. They're already outside. جزاكم الله خير. عاد كم شوي. Don't let any spaces. Our brothers outside are already standing in the sun. Fill up the gaps. جزاكم الله خير. بارك الله فيكم. اي نعم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى قال الله عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا عباد الله فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكلنا ضلالة في النار أما بعد الحمد لله رب العالمين We give thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who has made it from the ummah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ummah that will have the majority of the population in Jannah, alhamdulillah. The ummah who will be able to get the shafa'ah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on Yawm al-Qiyamah. The ummah who will be able to drink from the hawd and the pond of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For therefore Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, لَقَدَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ لَقَدَمَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعَثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا For verily it is a blessing upon the mu'min that he has sent down upon them a prophet. You imagine yourself as a Muslim without the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a guide. You imagine yourself as a Muslim not taking the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a role model. We speak about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We always wish that we have seen the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When we read the seerah, we wish we have been with the Prophet ﷺ and the Sahaba. We always do some kind of action that we want to be with him in Jannah and Yawm al-Qiyamah. For therefore, my brothers, we always talk. And sometimes the action does not affirm our speech. How many times we say that we follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a mercy to the whole of humankind. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ We have not sent you as a mercy to the whole of humankind. Your teaching, your ibadah, your way of dealing and interaction with the world and society is a rahmah for the people who look at you. That is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned أَطِيعُ اللَّهُ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ Indeed, in the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there is the best of example, the one whom you take as a role model. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we know very well, had actually gone through a lot of persecution. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sacrificed his family in order to be on the battlefield to keep al-Islam intact for the generation to come. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who would say, Ummati, Ummati, on Yawm al-Qiyamah, when everyone would be saying, Nafsi, Nafsi, on Yawm al-Qiyamah. For therefore, we think about it. We claim that we follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لما تقولون ما لا تفعلون كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون All those who believe, why do you say things that you don't actually put into practice? Look at our life, at our ibadah. How is our ibadah? صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي Do we pray like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? خذوا عني مناسككم. Do we make hajj like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do we actually deal with our spouse like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do we deal in our business transaction like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do we deal with the non-Muslim like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Think about it. Think about it before you say you're among the people who follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There are many people who claim they follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but the actions say the contrary. I'm not here to come and speak of the biography of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You can get that in books. But what we want to do is to actually open the mind of people where they actually claim things. And I'm guilty of that myself, that we say we follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but our action is contrary to that. Look at yourself every day in the mirror. I am from the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Out of all the ummah, Allah Azza wa Jalla has chosen me to be from the ummah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of ummah. Allah has given me this opportunity. He did not make from the ummah of Musa, wala Adam, nor Nuh, nor any of the Prophet, but the Prophet of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because Allah wanted khair for us. I look at myself in the mirror, am I one of the follower of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Am I those who are following the students of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba, the Tabi'in, Itba'i Tabi'in? This is the question. Leave yourself as an inquiry person in this dunya. Am I ready to meet Allah? If I meet the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would he allow me to drink from the health of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Oh, he would say, Ya Allah. Or the voice would say, Ya Rasulullah, for verily you do not know what they did after you left the dunya. One of the reasons why we always mention at the beginning of the khutbah, and that was the practice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. The best of his speech is speech of Allah Azza wa Jal, no doubt about it. خَيْرَ الْهَدِي, هَدِي النَّبِيِّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. By the time you have taken the guidance of someone other than the Prophet sallam, you are doomed to fail in this world and the akhirah. For verily the best of guidance, the best of teacher, the best of mentor, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What hadn't he teach you for you to leave the dunya? Can you come and say, no, this one I haven't been told by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I need to get that from other sources. He taught you everything in order for you to get the key of Jannah. He wants you to be with him, and he wants to see you. Where one day he told the Sahabi, I wish I would see my brother. I wish I would see my brothers. The Sahabi said, Ya Rasulullah, alaysa ikhwanik? The Sahabi said, are not we your brothers, Ya Rasulullah? He said, La, antum ashabi. You are my companions. My brothers are those who will come after me, believed in me, obey my commandments, and they die upon al-Islam. They are my brothers, and I wish to see them. He was crying on that day. Where are we? Are we among those people whom the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would wish to see? That's a question that you need to answer yourself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we raise under the shade of the throne of Allah azza wa jal with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be with the shuhada wa saliheen in Jannah. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Had our action or celebration or festival were to be one of the signs of our love of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Sahaba would have done it. The Tabi'een would have done it. The people who came of the third generation of the Prophet would have done it. Nowadays we claim we do some kind of celebration to show love toward the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. La wallahi abadan. Allah Azza wa Jalla does not look at your celebration. Allah Azza wa Jalla look at your effort in trying to follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Where we know very well we're approaching the 12th of Rabi'ul Awwal. You may see in many regions that the celebration is going on, will be going on. And people who've been the first and foremost ranked to celebrate that, they are not those people who are in Salat al-Fajr, wallahi. The people who are in the first rank and first row of Salat al-Fajr, they understand the concept of loving the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, just like the Sahaba did. For therefore, going back to the statement where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned, وَشَرَّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. Every kind of innovation that is put after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam in the religion to please Allah azza wa jalla are rejected. For therefore, anything that you do to please Allah azza wa jalla in regards to ibadah that was not there by the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, nor the Khulafa al-Rashidun, it will be rejected. مَنْ أَحْدَثَ فِي أَمْرِنَا هَذَا مَا لَيْسَ مِنْهُ فَهُوَ رَدْ. For therefore, yes, we know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was born in Rabi' al-Awwal. Na'am, ikhtalaf al-ulama in the date. Let's say we say, okay, he was born on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, khair. Walakin, what did the ummah do on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, the student of the teacher Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? This will determine our way of following the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Let's love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more. Let's put his teachings into practice. Let's leave the innovation, the darkness of shirk outside the purity of Islam. For therefore, any kind of innovation, any kind of ibadah that you do, go back to the Quran and the authentic source of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The matter of fact, al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam was confirmed. He passed away on the 12th of Rabi' al-Awwal, in the 11th year of Hijrah. And many people, they tend to celebrate that day, believing he was born on that day. So now you can ask the people, what kind of celebration you are doing? You answer that yourself. Let's see what the Prophet ﷺ has done, what the Sahaba has done, the Itba' Tabi'in and Tabi'in has done during these months. Had this month, Rabi' al-Awwal, been a special month, the Prophet ﷺ would have mentioned it. Walakin Allah Azza mentioned the 4 months of Rajab, Dhul-Hijjah, Dhul-Qi'dah, Muharram as a sacred month. Rabi'ul Awwal is not part of the sacred month. Your ibadah has to go back to the way of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the understanding of the Quran according to the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the teaching of the early predecessors. هذا وصلوا وسلموا على من أمرتم بالصلاة والسلام عليه. قال الله تعالى إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وآل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارفعنا مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. اللهم اهدنا لأحسن الأخلاق والأعمال لا يهديها لأحسنها إلا أنت، واصرف عنا سيئها لا يصرف عنا سيئها إلا أنت. اللهم احفظ دولة الإمارات من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن، وأدم عليه الأمن والأمان يا رب العالمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر، ولذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.